I'll move on to the next section, which is on the key 15 IDT action points for the September. Like I said, that September has already, we are halfway through September, and there are a lot of things which were required to be done in the month of September. So it's a quick snapshot of what all needs to be done so that you don't miss any timelines, you don't miss the bus for taking credits or any reportings or any rectifications that could be done in your returns. The first one, the rectification of errors or omissions in your GSTR 1 and 3B. September is the timeline where you can file, make all those amendments and the rectifications for any supply that has happened for the previous financial year, that is 1920. So wherever you find, you can quickly, you know, revisit your supplies, or maybe you would have got some information or some feedback from your customers also. So if you have any such open issues, pending queries from your customers, please quickly look at that, make those rectifications and amendments in your GSTR 1-3B. And then, because September is the month wherein you can make those changes, this is the timeline, because after you make these changes, after this month, there will be some, you know, repercussions. There will not be the person who's on the customer side may not get the credits or may not get the benefit of the rectifications that you're making. Second important thing is issuance of the credit note. Very important, because this is a credit note is something that has also implications on your books of accounts. You have to issue the credit notes for the invoices which are pertaining to 1920. Please take out any of those such scenarios, and specifically those cases where you are giving discounts, you are having, you know, any trade discounts or incentive schemes that you are running. Those types of transactions you need to highlight, pull them out, issue the credit note so that you don't end up paying extra taxes, because you'll not get the adjustments of the taxes that you have paid on the invoices if these credit notes are not issued within this month and reported in your September filing. Debit notes is another area where you need to keep on keeping a check that wherever you're giving any other additional, you're covering any additional charges from your customers, please issue those on time so that your recipient can avail the ITC. Otherwise, they might have difficulty of taking ITC on such debit notes which are issued after September. The fourth one is again very important for every business which is running today. Availment of ITC. Wherever you have missed on any ITC of any invoices or any debit notes, please quickly go back, look into those invoices. Wherever you had doubts, you were not able to take it within the period of that financial year. Today is the time, September is the time when you can take. So you need to look back, see any missing invoices where you have not seen. Because in practical scenarios, we have seen sometimes the invoices are somewhere lying in the system and they don't reach the, you know, team which has to book the credit. So maybe you can, you know, reach out to your teams and respective teams and get the details of any such invoices which is for the financial year 1920, take the credits, and you can accordingly finalize your returns for this September. Then comes GST audit. We know this is the timeline that has been given by the government, 30th September. They are hardly left with 12 days for the month, and please, you know, quickly finalize your audits. Whosoever is doing the audit for your organization, provide them all the information on a timely basis. Try and close it as soon as possible, because till date we have not heard any extension news. And let's not wait for the last days. Please be prepared for your audits, and so that you don't miss your any timelines. Common ITC calculation is again a very important aspect, because you would have done some calculations, ITC reversals, and then you would have, by the end of the year, there would be some finalizations of those reversals. So please again go back, look into those reversals, do them. If there is any short reversal, please pay that. If you have reversed extra, reclaim those credit, because you'll not get the opportunity to reclaim this credit then. So effectively look into all your ITC aspects. Similarly, Rule 36(4) calculation. Because of the COVID-19 situation, the government gave us the benefit to do a cumulative calculation for February to August. And you have to do this in the month of September. So you need to do it. If you miss this, then you might end up paying some interest liabilities in case, you know, you take extra credits, which is beyond the permissible limit. Wherever there are any RCM liabilities, please see all your RCM purchases, import of services, unregistered purchases, wherever you are liable to pay taxes. this is the time you can pay your taxes and take the credits also, because maybe you may be able to pay the taxes at a later stage, but the credits may always be disputed in future if you take the credits at a later stage. If you have any compliance, appeal, show cause notice, etc. for any previous law, pre-GST regime, excise, customs, etc. and the due dates for which were due from 20th March to 29th September, 30th September is the deadline. Please quickly go back and see if you are still having some pendencies. 30th September is the last extended deadline by which we can file those appeals. Otherwise, again, you face the rigors of non-compliances. Another requirement that has come up from the law is about the e-invoicing, and the government has declared 1st October as the date for go live for the businesses having turnover more than 500 crores. So please see where are you on date, how is your system preparation going on, whether you have started the testing of your solutions or whosoever solutions you have been taking. Whether you have mapped the fields, you are ready to go within in next 10 days, because 1st October is something which government is looking at, and we need, when it's 1st October, we need to be ready at least a week before, so that the first invoice that you are issuing on the 1st of the October, it is going on to the IRP portal for generation of the e-invoice. There's another change that happened over the customs rules, customs notification. The rules of origin have been changed. New rules have come, which is effective from 21st September. Please see what all requirements are there, what our documentation is, because it's more of a documentation work that has to be done. It's some extra obligations that have been imposed on the importers to ensure that whenever they are taking the benefit of any free trade agreements. So see what is the requirement, what is the procedures that you need to follow, what is the documentation has to be taken, because any import that is happening after 21st September will have to follow the rules of Karata. Then MEI scripts, FTF, FTT compliances, RCNG certificates, other returns. So these are anything which is falling on the in the month of September. Please ensure that you are doing their renewals. So for example, scripts, if you're having scripts which are expiring on 30th September, please use them, utilize them for payment of your duties. Otherwise, you'll not get anything out of it. Any FTP compliances, any advance authorization which is expiring, get the license renewed. RCMC is expiring, get them renewed. Normal returns, of course, whatever is due date, please follow those due dates.